WIGO AM 1570, Atlanta's Incredible Radio.
Now I remember one day when I was down and out and I couldn't see my way through. He picked me up and he turned me around and he made me new. And I remember one day when I was down and out and I couldn't see my way out. He blessed me. Yes, he did. And he made me brand new. Oh, let me say it again, y'all. Now I remember one day when I was down and out and I couldn't see my way through. He picked me up and he turned me around.
Word of God on Atlanta's Incredible Radio, WIGO AM 1570.
In order to be free, you have to know the truth. Pastor Lionel Gantt seeks to use the truth of God's word to help stop the tide of violence and mass incarceration used to enslave people all across this nation. Now, the word of truth by Pastor Lionel Gantt.
I am looking for freedom, looking for freedom.
Glory to God, glory to God. It's another Tuesday and another third day of the week, and we're coming to you with the radio broadcast of the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And I'm here today with my guest, Brother Sims from the Nation of Islam, and we're going to be talking about the situations and the circumstances that are happening here in America today. And before we get started with that, I want us to go into a word of prayer. Father God, we come before you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We come before you thanking you for this day, Lord. We realize, O Heavenly Father, that without you, we could do nothing, Lord. Father God, right now we ask that you bless this nation, bless our people, Lord. Help us and strengthen us in every way. Father God, we ask that you bless the church, Lord. Cleanse the church, Lord, and strengthen the church. As this word go forth, Lord, we ask that you heal our nation. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, we've got a lot of situations going on in America today. Everybody now is talking about taking a knee, and they're talking about the situation that's going on with Kilpatrick and all the stuff that is happening with the NFL. And we had a young girl that they found in the freezer I believe she was murdered, but they're still investigating those things today. Let me tell y'all something. They're taking our daughters right now today. They're not taking them you know, for prostitution or to make money with them selling their bodies or anything like that. They are taking our children now for their body parts. For their body parts. To sell their organs. To sell their organs on the black market.
Yes, sir.
Listen, this thing is getting, you have to pay attention to what's going on in America today. Now we're talking about taking the knee. When he first took the knee, they fired the man because they said he was disrespecting the flag. No, he wasn't disrespecting the flag. The flag is disrespecting itself. If America cannot live up to what the flag represent, if America cannot live up to its constitution,
that's
if America cannot live up to its creed that we hold these truths to be self-evident,
that's right,
that all men are created equal. Now, what America is saying is that, yes, all men are created equal except the black man in America. Because when they made that decree, we were enslaved at the time.
That's right.
So I'm going to go ahead and let my brother Sims come in and introduce himself, and then go ahead and give us a word on that.
My name is Cedric Sims. I'm Supreme Commander of the Black Panther Liberation Front here in Atlanta, Georgia. And it's so true what he's saying is that we have the right, and I don't have to wait for somebody, a white person, to give me the excuse or the people in power to celebrate or to stand up or protest for my benefit. And just one thing I want to reach out real quick. This is one of the part of the national anthem that has been ignored. And it says, "And where there is a band so violently swore the havoc of war on battle's confusion, a home and a country should leave us no more. And the blood has washed out their foul footsteps of pollution. No refuge could save the hireling and the slave from the terror of flight of the gloom of the grave. The star-spangled banner in triumph doth wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave."
Read that for them again, Brother Sam, because they don't realize that that's a verse. Read that again for them, because they don't realize that that is a verse that they excluding out of the national anthem. And it's not about the national anthem. You know, I'm a soldier of 21 years. I served in the military. I love America. I love my country. I was willing to die for my country. But the treatment of black America by America is unauthorized.
That's right.
It's un-American.
That's right. And where is that the band who so vauntingly swore and that the havoc of war and the battle's confusion, a home and a country should leave us no more. Their blood has washed out their foul footsteps pollution. No refuge could save the hireling and the slave from the terror of the flight and the gloom of the grave. And the star-spangled banner in triumph doth wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave.
And this is the national anthem.
Right.
This is the anthem. This is the anthem that they say that we disrespected, when this anthem is disrespecting us. So, America, I call you in check. I call you in check. And since this is a gospel radio station, I'm going to go into the Word of God. I'm going to go into Psalm, the 22nd Psalm, and I'm going into verse 22. And it said, "I will declare your name, my brethren, in the midst of the assembly, and I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. And all of the descendants of Jacob, glorify him. And fear him, all you offspring of Israel." America, who claims to be a nation of God. America, who claims to be a nation given to Christianity, how can you do such horrors to black America? Police are still shooting our children down in the streets, and we have no justice because they are not even brought up on charges. We're fighting a drug war in our communities where the drug war, Bruce Sim,
yes, sir.
It wasn't fought inside of Buckhead.
No.
They fought the drug war down on Bankhead.
That's right.
And they locked us up for $5 nickel bags and for dime rocks and giving our boys 20-year life sentences for drug charges. And this three strikes you out and the law they made about maximum sentencing, that was all put against our race. It wasn't done in white America, it was done in black America. So Brother Sam, I want you to go ahead on and chime in on what you think about the situation of America right now.
I think the situation in America is best reflected in Atlanta. I think it is horrible the way that we're being treated. And more so, it's going back to almost like it was during the segregation days in the 50s and 60s. The unwanted killing and the open killing of black Americans, where they be, whatever situation, from every demographic, from every wealth, that we are just openly and wantonly killed, and not even the video camera and not even the actual the sound and the sight of this crime being committed upon us is even enough to get a conviction. And I mean, that's horrible. That sounds like something back in the 60s, that people didn't get conviction for blowing up churches until years and years later, that people didn't get convicted of hanging people until years and years later. Some never got convicted or even found, you know, for the wanting slaying of black people. Doesn't that sound familiar?
So basically what was happening in the past, I think that a lot of the people in white America are being empowered by the presidency,
right,
of Donald Trump.
Hail Hitler.
And now they feel that they have the right to come out and show themselves. Now, we was under a black president, a president that was black for the last 8 years.
That's right.
And now they want to come out and show themselves as to who they are. Well, let me tell y'all something. This is America, all right? This is America. This is the land of the free. This is the home of the brave. This is the place where people come from all over the world seeking the opportunity of freedom. And as long as I live, America will stand for freedom. This is not just your country. This is my country also. And as I just read to you out of the book of Psalms, I'm going to go on down to the 23rd and the 24th verse where it says that, and for he has not despised nor abhorred the afflictions of the afflicted. Let me tell you something. God is watching over the nation.
Mm-hmm.
And those things that you think you're getting away with, you're not getting away with it. We are only as strong as our weakest link. And if me and my brother can come together, he's coming from the Nation of Islam, I'm coming from the church. If we can come together as black Americans, I'm asking you all to come together one and to begin to serve your community. I don't want to hear about another child being going to a party at night, and then all of a sudden she don't even make it back home. They find her, this girl's body, dead in a freezer. Look at here. We got to take accountability of our families. What we got to do is we got to start parenting again. So, Brother Sam, what message do you have for the black family today in these times that we're living in?
I believe that the black family should come back together. I believe that we should unite, that all of us are part of the family. You know, all children out there in the community that's suffering, or children that they're my children. I want to see them be safe.
That's right.
All the women out there are my mothers, my wives,
my sisters.
My sisters, right. You know, and every black person out there is my friend, you know, is my relative. So we have to really look in that perspective, and we should defend our communities within and without. We should defend our communities from the unwanted violence of the gang supporting, you know, and also against the people, the police, anybody that come in our community to attack people, to kill us, to put us in that situation. We should be able to fight back. We should be able to fight in the courts. We should be able to fight on the ground. We should be able to fight by any means necessary, through the political arena, to the lawyers, to any way that we can, to back up off this thing, and we can gain control of our communities.
Okay, I think I have a guest caller on the line. And she's going to tell us about domestic violence. You know, that's one of the things that is destroying our families. And I wanted her to chime in, give us an update as to where she is and what's going on with her, and to tell us what we need to do to turn our families around. I don't want to hear about another child being lost or killed or murdered, you know, out and a part of at night. So can we bring in our caller? And caller, can you please identify yourself and let us know who you are?
Praise God, yes. Thank you so much, Pastor Gantt. I am Reverend Dr. Unia Pettis, calling in from Washington, D.C.,
our nation's
capital.
You know I love you. I love you.
And I love you, and I thank you for telling the truth and nothing but the truth on your show. And this week, the Congressional Black Caucus Foundation met in the nation's capital, and I was honored to join Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee. She is the chair of the Congressional Black Caucus, and we held a panel discussion on domestic violence and the mass incarceration of black women.
All right.
And juvenile justice reform. So we talked about what's happening with black families, especially the need to bring more awareness and prevention for domestic violence. In October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. The entire month, we're going to hear more and more people talking about awareness and prevention. But I'm sick and tired as a preacher of turning on the news and seeing our young black girls and these children and babies being killed and beaten and destroyed, and our girls going missing because of they're in relationships that are toxic and they've fallen in love with the wrong person. So what I'm here to tell you is that one in four women are likely to be abused by their partner in their lifetime. And females, according to the Department of Justice, are victims of family violence at a rate three times more than that of males. And for every listener on this phone, on this station, WIGO in Atlanta, I want you to know that on average, every single day in the United States, three or more women are killed by their husbands or boyfriends. This has to stop. My ministry is called Nobody But God Outreach Ministries, and I'm a domestic violence survivor and advocate. My abuser was my pastor husband. No, you didn't mishear me. Yes, I was in the pulpit sitting next to him, and he was my abuser. I went in silence for 6 years because as a woman of God, I did not believe in divorce, and I did not believe that I thought I could change it by prayer and fasting, and I didn't tell anybody because I was ashamed and afraid and thought I could fix it on my own, and that if I prayed the abuse away, that it would stop. It started day one of our marriage. The night of our marriage, I came into my honeymoon suite, and he literally cursed me out and told me to get out the suite. I went downstairs to the hotel receptionist in my wedding regalia, afraid somebody was going to see me in the hotel because I had the hotel booked with family and friends. And I said, "Miss, my husband and I just had an argument." She's looking at me and saying, "But Miss, you got married today." I said, "Yes, just can you give me another key to another room?" I went in the other room, called the room, told him where I was, woke up that morning at 6 o'clock, which was a Sunday, and went to Sunday morning service because he let me back in the room and change. And I sat by him that Sunday, and I said, "You know what? The man I married yesterday was not the person I've been dating and being with for the last 2.5 years. He had never raised his voice, never treated me with disrespect, always was a gentleman. I wanted to wait till I was married to be intimate. He agreed with that, did everything that checked the list. But this man was a monster. So you do not know who you're with until they show their true colors. There are signs and warnings that I want to share with this audience. And I want to share this number. If you or someone you know is being abused emotionally, verbally, or physically, you can get help free today. If you're in immediate danger, call 911. If you're not in immediate danger, write this number down. It's 1-800-799-SAFE. That's 1-800-799-SAFE. and that's the National Domestic Violence Hotline. They'll patch you into free and confidential resources that will get you and your children out safely. You'll be able to record and document the abuse, and they'll put you in a safe house. You do not need to stay. If someone's hurting you, they're not loving you. And there are five warning signs that God has given me through doing this since 2007 through my ministry, Nobody But God. The first thing an abuser will do is isolate you, and that's monitoring the way your mail, your email, your phone calls. They'll isolate you from your friends and family, and they'll check on you all the time. The second I is intimidation. They'll make threats. They'll say, for instance, if you leave me, Unia, I don't know what I'll do. I'll kill myself. And the third one is interrogation. They'll badger you. Everything you do, where'd you go, who'd you see, who'd you talk to, all those types of questions. So it's isolation, intimidation, interrogation. The fourth one, irrationalization. That's when they become obsessive. They'll text you. They'll show up unannounced to school, to work, to church. They'll harass you. They'll harass your family. They'll stalk you. That's when they've lost their common sense and gone into a state of madness and irrationalization. And the fifth and the most deadliest is the incident of physical abuse. Oh. That's where they go from emotional and verbal abuse or financial abuse, and that's when they start slapping you, restraining you, pushing you, and God forbid, killing you. I go to enough funerals. I go to enough mothers who have buried their daughters and are raising their grandkids, and they always say, I wish, say, for instance, Keisha or Sheila or Tamika, I wish she would have left Reverend Pettis. We kept telling her not to go back, but she kept saying, Mama, he's my baby's father. Mama, he's going to change. Mama, he loves me. Let me tell you, young lady, if you're listening on this line, love does not hurt. And thank you, Pastor, for allowing me to share that.
You.
I hope
thank
it saved
you.
Someone's life. Again,
thank
October
you.
Is National Domestic Violence Month. And the number, if you're in trouble, 1-800-799-SAFE. And if you want to reach out to me, my name is Reverend Dr. Unia Pettis, UNNIAPETTUS. And my website is uniapettis.com. And I thank you again, man of God, for speaking up where others are being silent.
I thank you. I love you, sister.
I love you. I love you so much.
And
God bless
you
and the WIGO radio family.
Amen. We need you to come back in. You know we'll be calling you back.
Amen. God bless you.
All right. God bless you. Do we have another call on the line? Is Minister Latasha on the line? Okay, we were trying to get Minister Latasha on the line. She's running for city council here in Atlanta. She's another sister that is tremendous. You know, she brought up her children. She went through domestic violence. She went through a lot of issues with her husband and was finally left there on her own and found herself homeless. And then had to work her way back up. Now that sister has gotten her master's degree, and she has turned her life around. And now she is running for city council. And she's one that's out there representing us because she know what we've been through. She know she's representing the poor. So I'm asking you all to make sure y'all remember her on November and get out and vote. And that's another thing. That we're gonna have to do as Black Americans, we're gonna have to get to the poll. You know, this last election was won by Donald Trump because the majority of us didn't even go out to vote. So, Brother Sims, I'm gonna ask you to come in on that and to piggyback off of Dr. Pettis with the domestic violence. That's where most of us die. Most of us are not getting killed in the dope trap. Most of our children are not getting killed in some nightclub somewhere. Most of the death that is happening in Black America is happening by somebody that you know, by somebody that say they love you. All right, so go ahead, Bro Sam.
Yeah, I think domestic violence is unfortunate, And that goes into the problem, the black problem. And, you
know. When you say the black problem, what do you mean?
Well, you know, I mean that we all have been so manipulated and we have.
And we hate ourselves.
We hate ourselves. Uh-huh. And we, and you know, the lack of power, the lack of control of our lives sometimes bring to that problem confusion. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and also is that how men are delegated against not being respected, how we don't respect each other because guess what? We've been trained to teach this is a Negro. You can't trust a Negro. You know what I want to say, right? Mm. And that's the way we have these feelings. And we don't respect our, you know, our leadership. We don't respect our women. We don't respect our men. Yes, we're going to have these problems of abuse, right? So I think that's a problem that we need to deal with and squash. But one thing he was talking about, the vote. And the Juneteenth National Group is having a centennial of Fannie Lou Hamer. Okay. And Fannie Lou Hamer worked for SNCC. She brought the militant in the SNCC, as far as I'm concerned, because she risked her life, got herself beat up to get people a chance to vote in Mississippi. Now, our votes are very important. Now, you can have an argument, oh, well, the vote don't mean nothing. Well, it don't mean nothing if you don't get out there and vote, number one. And number two, if you don't choose the candidate that's going to represent you and work for your benefit, right? Malcolm X said, use the ballot and the bullet. He said, use your ballot like a bullet and aim at a target of choice and try to hit dead center, right? So this is how we need to identify the people that we elected. He mentioned Miss Holden, Dr. Holden. Mm-hmm. You know, she was impoverished. She was homeless, her and her children, right? And she brought herself up and, you know, and also got a Ph.D., mm-hmm. And now she's running for office. Now, those are the kind of people, and I'm not telling you to vote for her or anybody else, right? But those are the kind of people that we need that's going to represent us, that live the life that we live, that understands what poverty is, understand what homelessness is, and understand the problem that we're facing right now in our very communities. I don't care if you live out in Cascade, you live in the Bluff, you live in wherever you live at in Atlanta, there's homeless people right there in front of you. All you have to do is look around. There is our youth out there running aimlessly out in the street because they don't have the parental control.
Okay, we're down to our last 5 minutes. I'm going to go inside of the book of Jeremiah, Jeremiah 7, 5 through 7. And it says, for if you truly amend your ways and your deeds, if you truly practice justice between a man and his neighbor, if you do not oppress the alien, the orphans and the widows, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, nor walk after other gods to your own ruin, then I will let you dwell in this place, in the land that I gave to your fathers forever and ever. That is Amen. A promise that comes from God Almighty, saying that we got to treat each other right.
Right.
And we got to walk in love one toward another. That means white America, you got to walk in love toward black America.
That's right.
Black America, you got to walk in love toward white America. Brown America, yellow America, red America, everybody got to walk in love one toward another.
That's
and
right.
we got to be children of God. We got to stop all
That's
of
right.
this nonsense about trying to promote white supremacy. What are you promoting? What are you promoting? Black Americans have fought in every war that you have had.
Amen.
And we have shed blood right beside you.
All right.
This country is not just made for you. It is made for us.
That's
U.S.
Right.
United States for us.
That's right.
The U.S. It is for us. It's for all people from all nationalities. And Donald Trump, I serve you notice while you're talking about building a wall to keep the immigrants out. Your family was immigrants.
That's right.
They came here as immigrants. So are you going to put your own family out? Sir, I serve you notice. Today, God is in charge
That's
of
right.
America.
That's right.
Brother Sam?
Yes, you know, and that's correct, right? We've been a product of, we've been in this country. We have fought for this country. Now, even in the colonial wars, right? And that's what's so heartbreaking, that how are you going to talk against us, minimize our contributions to this country? And this country
we built this country.
That's right. We built this country. We built this country as free men, and we built this country as slaves. We made contributions in this country. And I want you to know that y'all forget that thing of slavery, y'all seen them 30, 40 years of that horrendous part of slavery, and know that we weren't just victims. We are creators. We created things in this country.
That's right.
We built this country in industry. We built this country financially. We built this country. We even framed the Constitution, challenged the Constitution, the Cable Amendments.
All right. Well, this has been the whole truth and nothing but the truth. We just now getting started. But we're going to deal with these situations and circumstances in America, and we're going to deal with them right here, WIGO Radio. And until next week, this is the whole truth and nothing but the truth.
We thank you for listening to The Whole Truth and Nothing But the Truth with Pastor Lionel Gantt. To find out more about Pastor Gantt and the Stop the Violence and Incarceration campaign, join them on Facebook at SCLC Stop the Violence and Incarceration Facebook group. You can email Pastor Gantt at GantLionelPastor@yahoo.com. That's GantLionelPastor@yahoo.com. Until next week, God bless you and be free.